chapter 14, statistics part 2, you will see some more problem from 14.1. So you read the third problem, very, very important. Okay, we have to find out the missing frequency. Okay, we have to find out the missing frequency. So very important. So the following distribution shows the daily pocket allowance of children of a locality. The mean pocket allowance is given. Using this mean, you have to find out the missing frequency. You see, in the tabular column, it is given the one frequency is not given. Instead of number, F is given. So this F you have to find out. For that, mean is given. So you have to, using direct method, easily you can do. Okay, you see the class is given 11 to 13, 13 to 15, this class is given. Clear? Same thing you write as daily pocket money. Okay, you write in rupees it is given, right? Write as, take it as class, continuous interval it is. So the number of children, that is 7, 6, 9, 13, F, 5, 4, it is given. Okay. Now, xi we have to find out. What is xi? Class mark, that is mid value. Mid value of this class, that is 12. Both add divided by 2, that is 24 by 2, 12. So now the class size is everywhere you see. All the class size is 2. So that you add 2. 2 add on means you will get. This is easy way, right? Now you have to what? Multiply this. You have to multiply this. You do the product here. 12 sevens are. To find out the product, 7 into 12, 84, 6 into 14, 84, 9 into 16, 144, 13 into 18, 234, then 20 into F, 20F, write separately, that is very important, okay, write separately, if you write here this, then you will add with this, so that you write separately, clear, then 5 into 22, 110, 4 into 24, 96, then add, these all add, means 752, right? Plus 20F unknown, right? That is what 20F, that is unlike term, write separately, that is, okay. Number alone, write first. Plus this with variable, write separately. Plus 20F, that is sigma F5 into XI. Now we have to find out sigma F5. Add all these things, means what you will get. 9, 22, 21, 44 plus F you will get. Now X bar, you know X bar equal to, what is X bar is given, that is rupees 18 is given, X bar, mean is given, right? Now what is X bar, you know the formula, sigma Fi into Xi divided by sigma Fi equal to 18, therefore, you substitute this sigma Fi into Xi, this is only this total is sigma Fi, that is 752 plus 20F divided by this sigma Fi, this total, that is 44 plus F is equal to 18, now cross multiply, okay, cross multiply 752 plus 20F is equal to 18 into this one cross multiply means 44 plus F, therefore 752 plus 20F is equal to 18 into 44 792 plus 18F. F and all bring one side, that means 20F minus 18F equal to 792 minus 752. So here 2F equal to how much? 40. Therefore F is equal to 20. This 2 you divide means F is 20. Frequency is 20. Answer, how to find out the missing frequency. This is the method. Sometimes what two missing frequency also they will ask. Then you have to form a linear equation in two variables. pair of linear equations to be able, then you have to solve means you will get F1 and F2. F1, F2 will be given, or X and Y will be given, right? So you can form here linear equations. Then you can solve means you will get, right? I will teach that one later on. Okay, now you practice this one. Thoroughly you practice. Very important problem. Clear? So next we will see the fifth problem. In a retail market, fruit vendors were selling mangoes kept in packing boxes. These boxes continued varying number of mangoes. The following was the distribution of mangoes according to the number of boxes. So first two number of mangoes given, 52, like that given. Clear? Number of boxes given, 1510, like this it is given. Find the mean of mangoes kept in a packing of box. Then which method of finding the mean did you choose? You just to think here, which method we can do for this problem. Means here you see somehow highest value given. So deviation method it is better. Clear? So but you notice here the continuous, here the intervals, you notice the interval, class interval, that is not continuous. Okay. In the histogram, in the graph, you have to make continuous. Now you see here the class size you have to see, that should be what same. Clear? Then only we can apply the deviation method. Class size you have to see. Yes, clear. Class size everywhere that is 2. Class size everywhere it is 2. Understand? That is very important, right? Now we will see the solution. First you write class. Class you write 52. Okay, xi is a mid value. You have to find out the mid value. What is the mid value here? 51. Here mid value 54. 57. Here mid value 59, 61. Okay, here mid value is 60. Here mid value 63. Right, like this correctly find out mid value. Here add these two divided by 2 means correctly we get. Okay, mid value, correct mid value, you write. Now you have to find out DA. You have to find out DA. So DA is nothing but XI minus assumed mean. That is assumed mean method we are doing. Clear? Assumed. So how to choose the assumed means? That is mid value of middle of the xi, middle of the xi, middle of the observation. That is 57. Okay, middle 57. Correctly middle getting. Sometimes you will get two data means. Okay, the highest number you choose better. So now 57 here. Okay, so 51 minus 57 minus 6. Minus only greater. Here minus 3. Okay. Then 57 minus 0. Then 3. Then 6. So these two multiply. Minus 90. This is minus 330. Okay. This and this. Yeah. 5 into DA. This one 0. Then these three multiply means 15. 4, 345, and these two multiply 25 into 6, 150. Right, add these two first, add these two, then add these two, then write 8. Add these two means how much you will get? Minus 420. Right, now these two add 5. Now subtract. 420 subtract means 575. Okay, 75 is sigma. FIDA is 75. Okay, this one is not required. This XI also not required. Sigma FI is required. Okay, I'm totally right. Okay, sigma FI how much? 600. Okay, sigma FI is 600. Now what you have to do, x bar, you have to write x bar equal to, you know the formula, assumed mean formula you write, okay. That is mean for assumed mean, that is x bar equal to a plus sigma fi into di divided by sigma fi. What is a? 57 plus sigma fi di, that is 75 by 600. Okay, that is 57 plus 25 dB. This will go 3 times, this will go 2 times, 100 means 4 times 25. Okay, then again 3 dB, it will go 8 times, 1 time 10. Okay, so 1 by 8, it is 1 by 8. That is equal to 57 plus 0 point, so that is equal to 57.125 or approximately 57.13. Okay, 57.13 is the mean. Okay, mean, which method for finding this mean means, you write assumed mean method. Okay, we use what are, this is called assumed mean method. This method is known as assumed mean method. So, assumed mean method we use here. Clear? Assumed mean method we use. Understand? So, practice well. Clear? So, next topic, mode of grouped data. So, in 9th class, you might have studied about mode of ungrouped data. Clear? That is, what is the mode of ungrouped data? The maximum number of time repeating observation. Clear? That is the which observation is occurred. Clear? Maximum number of times. Okay, frequently occur observation. That is what mode of ungrouped data. But mode of grouped data, we have one formula. Clear? Using this formula only, you have to find out the mode of grouped data formula. That is mode equal to L plus F1 minus F0 whole divided by 2 into F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H. Clear? So L is lower limit of the model class. What is model class? Nothing. Model class is nothing but a class with the maximum frequency. A class, which class is having maximum frequency, that class is called model class. Okay, that class is called model class. Now, H is the size of the class interval. H is the size of the class interval. Okay, then F1 is the frequency of the model class. F1 is the frequency of the model class. Model class, which frequency having, that is F1. Okay, F0 is the what frequency of the class preceding the model class, just preceding the model class. Then F2 is a frequency of the class succeeding the model class. Succeeding the model class. You see one example. Find the you will see the on exercise 14.1. First problem. Find the mode of the following data. Age in years given, that is class given. Number of patients given. Okay, that is frequency. Okay, this one is class interval, this one frequency is given. Clear? In that, you have to see the highest frequency. This is highest frequency. This is highest frequency. This is called model class. Therefore, model class is right. Model class is what is model class? 35 and 45. In this, the lower limit is L. L is 35. Okay, L is 35. Understand? Lower limit is L, that is 35. Next, you see, H is class size, H is class interval, class size of the class interval. Class size is what? Everywhere, how much it is there? 10, 10. Clear? Class size is 10. 5 to 15, 10. Okay, so H is what? 10. Next, what you have to find out? F1 is frequency of the model class. This is model class. Okay, you mark it. This is model class. Whose frequency is F1? This is F1. F1 is 23. Okay, 23. Next one. F0 is the frequency of the class preceding. Preceding was before that. Clear? F1. This one is preceding frequency. That is F0. F0 is preceding. Then F2 is succeeding. F2 is succeeding of the class. Okay. F2 is the frequency of the class succeeding the model class. F2 is the frequency of the class succeeding. Succeeding means after. Clear? This one F1 before one. This one after one. That is F2. So 0, 1, 2 like that will come. Center is F1. Okay. Before F0. After F2. Like this you have to remember. Okay. So if you correctly write this value, easily you can do. F0 is 21. F2 is how much? F2 is 14. Okay, now we have to put the value in this formula, then easily you can write. Okay, so you should know the meaning of this formula. That is mod equal to L plus. You see, easily you can write the formula. Okay, the same way you write. First, you write the numerator F minus F divided by the denominator F minus F. Numerator 2F. Between minus you have to do. Right. Now what I am going to do is here 1, 0. 1 minus 0 is 1 always. Okay. Easily you can subtract 1 minus 0. Okay. Here you put in the center you put 0. Center you put the 0. Okay. Here 1. Same 1 minus 0. Here you put 2. This 2 you bring it here. 2F1. So, okay. Easily you can write the formula. Understand? You with idea, you easily can remember. Okay, like this you write, you will not forget. Into H, that is very important. Into H. Okay, into H is very important. Okay, now you put the value according to this problem. Clear? Model class, L, H, B, F1, F0. Clear? Just to replace. So what is L here? Define. The simplification part correctly, how to do? Correctly, you substitute 23 minus 21 by 2 into F1, 46. Write it straight away. Here, F1, you know, double it and write minus F0, 21 minus F2, 14 into the H is how much? 10. Okay, so 35 is separated. Here. Now these two multiply, I mean subtract means 2. This one 46 minus both add minus how much? 35 into 10. Right. So 35 plus this one is how much? 2 by 11 into 10. That is equal to 35 plus that is better. That also is. It will go one time, right? It will go one time. Okay, then point you give. Remainder for 90. 8 times will go. 90, 8 times will go. Again, because 11, 8 or 88. That's why 8 times will go. Okay, so that is equal to 35.1.89. Always keep 2 digits, right? So decimal integer part you add is 36.89. This is mode of the given data. Clear? In the problem they asked, okay, in the first problem they added finding mean and compare. Clear? Mean and mode you have to compare. Okay. So exercise 14.2, the second problem we will see. The following data gives the information on the observed lifetimes in hours of 225 electrical components. Total 225 electrical components. So the lifetime in hours given in intervals, then frequency given. Here, frequency given. So the lifetime in hours 0 to 20, 20 to 40, 40 to 60, 60 to 80, 80 to 100, 100 to 120, okay, then 10, 35, like this it is given. So in this, first what you have to see, highest frequency, maximum frequency is how much? Max frequency, right? Maximum frequency. Maximum frequency is 61. Therefore, model class, immediately write model class. Model class is 60 and this is highest frequency. So, model class you make it box 60 to 80 for our convenience. So, this is L. Okay. Therefore, L is equal to 60. L is equal to 60. What is H? Class interval, that is 20. Class size is what? 20. So that is H. H means class size. Now what is F1? This is F1, frequency of the model class F1. The preceding one F0, the succeeding one F2. Clear? So like this you write it. What is F1? 61. F0, 52. F and in F 238, right? All values writing. Now we have to write the formula. Okay, therefore mode equal to L plus, write the formula correctly. Numerator 2F between minus equal. Numerator 3F between minus equal. Okay, 1, 0, 0 center, 1, 2, this 2 you bring it here. Into H. Okay, so write correctly this formula. Then L is low element, that is 60. Put correct value. F1 is 61 minus F0, 52. 61 minus 52 by 2 F1. F1 is 61. Double it, 122 minus F0, 52 minus F2, 30 into H is 20. This is 9 by this one, 122 minus add means 0 to 20, right? 32 into 20. So here you cancel. This is 10, this is 16. Okay, so 60 plus 90 by 60, 90 by, therefore you add this integer part, means 60 plus 5, 65, then write a decimal part as it is. Here, this is only what mode, this is only mode, understand? Model lifetimes of component. Go to write final answer like this. Understand? Okay, so very simple. Mode is very simple. Only remember the formula. Okay, then each and every term meaning, if you okay. Remember, means the tabular column, same what is given in the problem, same tabular column, you have to what? You have to find out F1, L, model class, L, then F2, F0, then H means, then substitute the value means you easily will get, okay? Okay, so in the tabular column, given tabular column itself, you have to find out all values and put the value, clear? And easily you can get the answer, okay? So same type of problem I will give it as homework. Okay, do the homework problem. Before that you do all classwork problem and formula you write. Okay, several times write and see. Understand? Then only it will come. Okay, I thought one method also. Use the method and write and see several times. Easily you can remember.